Hello friends, today I want to discuss what are the top 5 books for software architecture or high level design. These books you can read independently of each other or in combination with each other. So our number 5 is .NET application, building applications for enterprise by Don Esposito. I hope I am pronouncing his name correctly. If you are in C# Microsoft technology, and you don't want to read too much theory, too much mumbo jumbos, you want to read architecture book in a simple language, have C# examples, this book is for you. It's a very good startup books if you are new to design architecture and you have some knowledge of C#. He describes the role of solution architect. He describes what are the different architecture patterns, what are the different design patterns, what are the good practices. Our number 4 is Software Architecture in Practice. This book is very heavy on theory. I think this book should be, I personally believe that this book should be taught in computer science colleges. This book discusses the architecture of different applications. This book used to have a lot of hardware examples. Now we have third edition. They are focusing more on the software architecture. They discusses a lot of things about architecture in details, why architecture is important, what are the different architecture qualities, how the software architecture matter in today's agile world. So it's a great book. You need to have a lot of time, a lot of patience, and it's heavy on theory. Our number 3 is Clean Architecture by Uncle Bob. Uncle Bob is a very popular person in software engineering. So in this book, he talks about good principles of component design. He discusses how you can use solid principles. Solid principles are very popular design patterns. He discusses what kind of impact these solid principles have on overall architecture. He discusses about microservices. He discusses the disadvantage of using a single database in microservices, where you give away the advantage of microservices. So you have a good foundation knowledge to make the most of from this book. And number 2 is Evolutionary Architecture by Neal. This book gives you a roadmap or mindset how to deal with architectural issues in agile world. He nicely discusses in agile world, we let the architecture evolve. We let the architecture characteristics, what is important from architecture point of view, is performance important, is scalability important. So find out the factors which are important. And make sure you have written some tests if your application need to be scalable for, let's say, 1 million users. So you need to write tests to make sure that your application is able to handle 1 million users. So this book discusses very nicely what happens in we come with architecture when we start the application. And as we build more features, like a lot of architecture attributes, qualities, scalability, performance, it starts degrading over the time. Using evolutionary architecture framework, we can make sure that these architecture important qualities of the system should not degrade over the time, and it should evolve. You should discover what is important from the business users rather than making assumptions about the system itself. Our number 1 is Fundamental of Software Architecture by Mark Richards and Neal Ford. So friends, if you are looking for a book which talks about engineering aspects, gives you some practical tools, how to monitor the architecture of your application, how to make sure that your application architecture qualities don't degrade over the times. It also discusses about the soft skills of an architect. Lot of people and books, I am guilty of that. We used to think, oh, architect, I am not good with people. I don't want to manage people. Okay, I will work hard, read technology, and become a software architect. So there is a news for you guys. If you have been watching my channel for some time, I discuss software architect needs more soft skills than technical managers, because as a software architect, nobody would be reporting to you. So you need to have more soft skills, more management skills, more priority skills to be a successful software architect. You have to have a lot of negotiation skills. So this book discusses that there are few software architect jobs I have seen personally, the places I have worked. For five technical managers, there is one software architect. So there are few jobs, high competition, and you need to have a lot of soft skills. This book discusses the soft skills to be a successful architect. So friends, if you like this video, I have detailed reviews of software architecture books on my channel. Do watch them. Also like it, share it, and subscribe to my channel for your regular updates. Connect with me on LinkedIn and Twitter, especially LinkedIn, if you like small summaries of the video. I will be posting a lot of small summaries of the video on LinkedIn. Thanks again.